think it's the future of rock and roll.
Yes. Warren, I understand that the grassroots and you had kind of a wild experience not long ago. You saved somebody's life.
Yeah, it was about a month ago. We were in a small airport in Chico, California, and there was this old man who had been semi-violent with his remarks about hippies and people that dressed a little unusual. And he suddenly collapsed, and his face went blue. And
talk about being uptight.
We went over and we loosened his collar and took out his false teeth and gave him Creed right here, our lead guitarist, gave him mouth-to-mouth resuscitation, and we brought him back to life. And on his way out on the ambulance, he said he'd never say a bad thing about a hippie again. So we did
good
our deed little
done.
Deed to humanity.
That's a very touching story, and it's kind of wild. The grassroots is performing in front of a lot of different kinds of audiences these days, teeny boppers and college crowds and concerts. Do you style your music differently for each group?
Well, the music really stays basically the same. When we're playing to, like, let's say, an underground audience, we can improvise more, and they'll be there just listening to musical and lyrical content. And when you play to the teeny boppers, it's a lot of fun. They go for a totally visual thing, where you can really goof around and have a lot of fun. And then when you play to the college campuses, you can communicate more, you can speak more, and you can give your viewpoints and such.
Well, I know that one of your biggest hits was Live for Today, and I wonder whether that may be kind of a personal expression of your own philosophy.
Yeah, we sort of are all from the existentialist school, and we don't like to sort of burden ourselves down. We like to stay as loose as possible and sort of live each moment for each moment.
A number that I dig very much that you do is Bella Linda, and I wonder whether you might do that for the kids.
Fine,
now.
Sure.
Would you?
Yeah.